Gaurav, first, Mr. Rahul Gandhi's job is now to defend the indefensible, which was when JNU had these anti-national forces raising slogans against the nation. He said those who are trying to stop them are anti-nationals. So the lesser said about Rahul Gandhi, the better it is. Issue is, when you are talking about Mr. Parikar's statement threatening Amir Khan, I want somebody to read out the statement. Let somebody say, this is what he said, and this is what he said. The statement said, one actor has said that his wife wants to live out of India. It was an arrogant statement. If I am poor and my house is small, I will still love my house and always dream to make a bungalow out of this. Now, where is the threat in this statement? Somebody.
No, no, the threat follows the threat. The threat, Mr. Mittal, the threat is where the minister, according to the Congress, it where they say that there was a group, he knows that group, that went after this online company, and this group went and ordered and then cancelled the order, ensuring that Snapdeal cancels Amir Khan as their brand ambassador. Was that a threat?
Wonderful. Now, is this a threat? A threat is when something happens and you say, I will teach you a lesson. He's saying, I know of people, how they reacted to it. Now, what is the illegality in what people have done? If people agreed by what Mr. Amir Khan had said, had done something, where is the threat in this, Baba?
Okay.
I mean, I think common English is something which should be understood by the Congress party as well as everybody.
CR Kesavan, respond to this. Sudhanshu Mittal says that the Congress party leadership does not understand common English. Where did the minister say that they issued a threat? He said, we know of people who did this. It is people power. Mr.
So first is, it should always, when we are debating, let us be to the point about what Parikarji said. He has no answer to that. Secondly, he's talking about all the allegations. He's forgotten the Tanchmal, which his own general secretary and his most prominent leader was talking about in terms of women. He's forgotten that wo cheez achhi hai, talked about by another general secretary of his own party. Arey, come on. You have a history of
come
such derogatory remarks. From right from Mautka Saudagars to I don't know what. But that's not the issue. I don't want to get into this. That's not the level of discussion I get into. This is a low level. I am saying what Mr. Rahul Gandhi had to say. Rahul Gandhi has to say RSS. First, where is RSS in this? Secondly, what did the minister say? None of them has been able to even pinpoint 1%. And look, that shows a mindset that any dissent to what they believe is right is looked with, is laced with such ridiculous allegations and such verbosity that it shames me. If you're a Democrat, then you must give me the right to dissent with you. If Mr. Parikar dissents with the act of Mr. Amir Khan, he is criminal. He is guilty. He is all what has been said by Mr. Razib, this thing, Surjawalas, and the Gandhis of Congress. I mean, give me a break. Not a word is said which is wrong. Not a criminality. I just heard the CPI leader talking about constitutionality. Mr. whatever his name is, sir, please explain to me, where is the constitution breached? And when people say they will not buy his goods.
No, no, sir.
When
please, people,
Mr. Halim, respond to that.
Constitutional ways
of teaching lessons
is acceptable to the minister.
Mr. Halim, did you hear what the defense minister said?
Please
explain me the unconstitutionality.
No, no, he's absolutely alluded to extra constitutional ways of teaching a lesson.
How is it extra constitutional?
If Mr. Manohar Parikar has a problem with anybody, why can he not execute his constitutional power? That means he is supporting people in behaving in an unconstitutional fashion.
Khan,
an extra constitutional way of behaving is acceptable to the minister.
So, if no, somebody orders something online and cancels it, it's a violation of the constitution, Mr. Halim. Mr. Halim, if somebody orders something online and then cancels that order, that is a violation of the constitution of India.
I am not alluding to that. What I am alluding to, Mr. Manohar Parikar has very clearly said that people have to be taught a lesson. My question is very clear. Whether it's Amir Khan or any other person, does the minister accept the fact that extra constitutional ways of teaching a lesson is acceptable to him?
Respond to that, Sudhanshu Mittal. Was the minister?
Answer the question simply.
You know, Sudhanshu Mittal. Sudhanshu Mittal, hear me out. Sudhanshu Mittal, hear me out. Sudhanshu Mittal. The allegation is, if Aamir Khan or his wife, if they were feeling uncomfortable in India because of their perceived, they may have perceived that it was rising intolerance. They may have perceived that intolerance was rising. Instead of reassuring the minorities, instead of reassuring them, was the minister rubbing their nose to the ground, sir?
What is the problem?
The minister here says people who talk anti-national must be taught a lesson by the people. Now, people's reaction is becomes unconstitutional. That is the most perverse of all arguments I have ever heard in democracy. He has specified people. People's reaction. People's strong reaction. Has he said violence? Has he said you take law in your own hands? What rubbish do we talk? What anti-democracy things do we talk? Give me, no, I mean, I am reiterating, Gauran.
Is
people's reaction is unconstitutional?
Mr. Sudhanshu Mittal, in this incident, you please tell me the constitutional remedy.
Sir, constitutional method is I have a right. I have a right to say, I will not let you
be condemning you.
Condemnation by people is a teaching without lesson. When people vote against the government, when people vote against the parties, they teach us a lesson. Now you are saying teaching a lesson by people is unconstitutional. How shameful.
Respond to that, Mr. Keswan. If we were to stick to the minister's statement, do you agree with Mr. Harlem saying that it's a violation of the constitution? Where is the minister wrong if the minister says, how dare anyone speak against the country? Is the minister wrong? Okay, gentlemen, everyone talking at the same time will not achieve any results.
Can I make a statement, please?
Nitin, respond to that, the context. Gentlemen, let me ask Nitin Gokhale to tell us the context of that statement first.
Who called Godse a patriot? It was a BJP MP who called Godse a patriot. And where was this constant?
How does Godse come into where I'm asking Gokhale a question? Mr. Gokhale, please respond.
Talk about homilies, about freedom of expression.
Gaurav, can you let the Gokhale come in?
Yes. Okay, Mr. Keswan, can we pause the Godse and go to Mr. Gokhale, please? Go on, Mr. Gokhale. Nitin.
Yes. Gaurav, somebody asked, I don't know who asked the context. The context was a book on Siachen. It was being talked about patriotism, about the army, about the people who serve the nation and protect the nation. And in that context, this entire topic came up. He said, those people who serve the nation feel very let down that there are people who speak against the country. And that's where it started, that remark. And then he said that I'm not speaking against any university, any organization. There was this actor whose wife felt insecure. But there are people who felt angry about that remark. And they took the legal means of boycotting him. The entire freedom struggle was won by boycotting British goods and doing satyagraha. So that is the way it was done. And all that he said, that I am aware that there was a team that was done. There was a fellow called Suresh Nakhua, who I just learned today had started the uninstalling of the application on Snapdeal, and people started joining him. Log bante gaye, karwa banta gaya.
The BJP does not have a brief. The BJP has not contributed to the freedom struggle of India. They have not participated in any way.
Gaurav,
none of the leaders have participated. They have no legacy. They have
gone with the Marxist nationalism.
All my guests, can I respond? BJP was only formed in 1987.
No, Sudhanshu
BJP
Mittal.
Was formed 1980.
Yes, please live up to that reputation that was formed in 1980.
The allegation is that the minister was adding fuel to fire.
Please, sir, don't make false statements. You are on a national channel. Don't make false statements.
And all these people were born after 1980.
You just heard the biggest lie from Mr. Keswan.
Nitin Gokhale, will the minister's government involved in those who are targeting actors like Aamir Khan? Is this targeting free speech? Was the minister targeting free speech, Mr. Gokhale?
He wasn't at all. He was just giving the general talk about how people get angry when some people speak against the nation. It was a book on the Siachen the Operation Truth. It was in that context how army men are protecting protect our freedom, protecting they are on the border, they are deployed on the border, they are protecting our freedom, they are protecting the nation. And in that, when some people speak against the nation, they get hurt. It was in this context that he was speaking. I am only speaking about that particular speech. I am not getting into the constitutional, unconstitutional thing. But in my view, as a journalist, there was nothing unconstitutional in what the minister said. All that he said was some people resorted to boycott of a company which Aamir Khan was representing, and it was completely legal. It was a legal method which was used. Tomorrow, if you don't like me, all channels don't like me, you can boycott me. That will hurt my commercial interest. Is that unconstitutional? Can I take you to court, Gaurav?
Okay.
Gaurav, you just heard Mr. Keswan. With impunity, he lies. He says he had prior knowledge, prior information. By this statement, where is the prior information? But just to prove a point, they have brought polity to such low levels that they can lie with impunity against anybody. Secondly, you just heard the CPM, CPI. Not a word against the gang rape of women in Uttar Pradesh, because they are the potential allies. Not a word about two Dalits who were killed because they owed somebody 15 rupees. Not a word by them. And what is the debate? A debate about constitutionality, about where...
Sudhanshu Mittal, those are issues that we are raising concretely.
What is happening? Well, those are issues that are at least here in India today.
Please don't speak. Don't speak in between.
Nitin, have some decency. Was the minister close on the Nitin processes were there? Was the minister inciting people? Or was he talking
to people? They have to talk nonsense. They have to hold the Lok Sabha...
Gaurav, I will just say this. Gaurav, I am only talking about the function in which Mr. Parikar spoke. I am telling you it's a non-issue. It was in the context of the book's launch and the army people and the audience that was there. He did not incite anybody. He was very mild. It was like an anecdote that he was sharing, that people will not tolerate anybody. There is no question of the minister targeting anybody or inciting anybody in that particular thing. The video is out there. And if people do not understand Marathi, please go to the translation that the tweets that I have made. And somebody who reported, in fact, the only report came in one newspaper.
Okay.
27 other newspapers reported that function. Not one reporter reported about this because they understood. They were all people who understood the language. I think there was a problem in understanding the language.
Okay.
There was a word substituted. Amche loka, he never said. Amche is our people. He never said our people. He said loka. That means people.
Yes.
Generally, he's talking about general people. So let's get that straight.
And
if
that is exactly what the minister
language,
has also said.
It's a non-issue as far as I'm concerned.
Nitin Gokhale, Mr. Keswan, Mr. Halim and Sudhanshu Mittal, many thanks for joining me here on the debate. On the other side of a short break, we'll talk about that brutal highway gang rape of a woman.